publishing a special edition of Weekend Sunrise with extensive coverage of the stabbing rampage at Bondi Junction.
We continue to learn more about this violent attack, which took place at one of Australia's biggest shopping centres, as more details come to light this morning. We're confirming that 7 people are dead. A dozen others are in hospital after that knife-wielding man attacked innocent shoppers.
Let's go now to Shervo, who was right there on the ground at Bondi Junction, giving us the very latest. Now, Shervo, we've just learned some new details from police.
Yeah, that's right, Mon. The second victim has been identified. It is another female victim, of course, 5 of the 6 that passed away yesterday. And it's been named as Dawn Singleton, 25-year-old daughter of Australian businessman John Singleton, and her mother, Julie Martin. Just a horrific event happened here yesterday, and to understand the identities of these people and the significant impact that it's going to have on those families. So she was 25 years of age. She's understood to have been due to marry her New South Wales police officer partner, who she'd been high school sweethearts with. She attended Ascombe College just down the road from here, not too far away. And as we've touched on, Bondi Junction is it's a gathering point for the eastern suburbs, but then a wider Sydney community as well. It's on the fringe of the CBD. It's not far from Bondi Beach. People come here to shop, to eat, to go to the cinema, to enjoy themselves. It's a safe place, and we just have that's all changed in the last 24 hours. We don't fully understand the impact it's going to have going into the future. So just to reiterate, the second victim has been identified as Dawn Singleton, the daughter of Australian businessman John Singleton.
Yeah, just 25 years old as well, Shervo, and obviously as the morning goes on, more of the victims will be identified, and those medical teams still in the hospitals working overtime to help with the casualties. 2 of the dozen or so that have been treated and hospitalised remain in intensive care.
Yeah, we understand 12 people being treated in hospital.